What is the best way to level up in Assassin's Creed Odyssey? With a lot of new players playing the game for the first time during the free weekend that happened recently, I thought it would be nice to make a cool updated video on how to level up fast in 2020. I also recently upgraded my microphone, so there's now better audio than in those previous videos about the same topic. So let's get into it. A like on the video would be super appreciated, and let's go. Maybe you already saw one of my videos on the story creator mode missions that were in the game months ago, where you could just enter one of these portals and then instantly go to the max level and get a ton of extra ability points and also the maximum amount of drag me. Well, that is sadly all removed. I mean, I totally get it because it kind of broke the game, but the story creator mode is of course still active and there are still some missions that give you a decent amount of XP. So you can activate this feature in the settings, go do it if you haven't already, and then via the quest menu you can go to stories and add new ones, and you can also add new ones via the in-game browser. Of course, good to note is that you have to play the game with an internet connection to be able to activate this feature. So I found two pretty good quests called Epic Battles in Cephalonia that has you fight many enemies, and during this mission you get a pretty decent amount of XP. So again, there are two different versions of basically the same mission, and one gives you more XP, so I would totally recommend that you do the one that is over here on the map, so not the one on the beach, although you can of course switch them up if you want some variety. They both take a few minutes to complete depending on your build. I got around the 20,000 XP for the one on the beach and 35,000 XP for the other one, but the amount of course varies per level. Just try and do some AoE attacks like the multi-shot and the overpower ability from the spear and the staff, and you should be able to kill these enemies pretty fast. I will, by the way, put links to these missions in the video description so you can easily add them to your quest log via the website. So here you have to log in with your Ubisoft Club account, and that Ubisoft Club account has to be linked to the account in your game, and then you see the missions show up. There's also one quest that is more similar to those previous XP farm missions that were in the game. This one of course does give you way less money and XP, but you get it by doing nothing. This one is called Rulo Dol, and also on Cephalonia. Just start it and talk to Herodotus, then select the first option, not the second option, otherwise the quest will be failed. No, just pick the top option and then you have to wait, and the XP will come in. After that, you can talk to Herodotus again, and then you complete the mission. And I got around the 24,000 XP on this level 70 character. Good to note is that I'm not using the XP boost in this video, so if you have that, then you of course get 50% XP on top of that. If you're not familiar, the XP boost is something you can buy for Helix credits in the store, but there is actually also a short free version in the Ubisoft Club section of the game, so totally get it if you haven't already. But when you claim it, you immediately activate it, so then it's smart to go to your XP bar and pause it. And it will actually be smart to only activate it right when you are about to complete a quest or a ton of bounties, for example. Like, totally play around with the pause button and only use it when you are about to get a ton of XP. And yes, bounties are still one of the best ways to level up in this game. So totally go check the message boards in every region and then go to the bounty tab in the quest menu to see what you need to do. I now have to complete two conquest battles for Athens, and that is nice because conquest battles already give you a ton of XP. So just search on the map where there's a conquest battle available, and I get like 55,000 XP per battle. And after that, I of course have to do the second one as well. And then after completing that one, getting XP from that conquest battle, I also immediately complete the bounty and get a whopping 150,000 XP on top of that. Linking bounties is also really smart. I now, for example, need to go to Focus to kill Spartan brutes and also loot one more national treasure from Sparta. So I can do both by going to the same fort in Focus. I kill the brutes, get a ton of XP, and then I can also immediately get the national treasure. So that's quite a lot of XP in a relatively short amount of time. The bounties will really give the most amount of XP, but sometimes you have to travel for quite a long time before you reach the location for the objective of the bounty. And during that downtime, you'll of course not be earning any XP. repeating the story creator mode missions over and over again will, for example, have no downtime, just like another activity that I will talk about in a second. First, I quickly want to touch on something else though, something that is smart to do at any point in the game, and that is looking at the current power of a faction in a specific region. When you namely see that a faction is weakened, you can go help that region and get a treasure or kill the leader to trigger a new conquest battle that you can then easily do to get some nice extra XP. During these battles, it's smart to focus on the captains to make it go a little bit faster, and here also the AoE moves are really nice to use to lower the forces of the enemy faction as soon as possible. And also good to note is that when a region switches from Athens to Sparta or the other way around, then you should find new bounties on the message board in that region. So that's why it's also worth it to keep an eye out for the weak factions and flip the control. There's also another way to get fast XP in Odyssey, one without any downtime, just like the story creator mode missions, and that is the arena. It's over here on the map, as you might know, and here you can fight a mercenary, something that I would always try and do first, because this fight already gives you XP, and they also get the regular arena XP on top of that. And these fights are normally shorter than fighting the waves of enemies and then the arena boss in the regular arena options. After you kill the mercenary though, he will take some time to reappear, so then you want to focus on the King of Bandits option to get some pretty fast XP. It is good to know though that this works on level 50 and up, because otherwise I don't think you can replay these arena fights because they are linked to a quest. But after you complete that, you should be able to do these challenges over and over again, and then you will be rewarded with the same amount of XP each time, and the higher your level, the easier and the faster you kill these level 50 opponents. So totally worth the farm, but sure, doing the same arena level over and over again will get repetitive over time. So totally try and switch it up with maybe other arena levels and other things that I mentioned in this video. I also checked if the nice XP farm from It's Jordan does still works, and it does. So for this one, we want to go to Beotia, because here you got a leader, national treasure and war supplies all in one fort. So you can all do them to lower the nation power with one run. You do have to kill some other enemies as well to get the notification that the conquest battle is ready, but that is easily done when doing the multiple objectives. And what is nice is that the conquest battle is very close, so from the fort you can easily go there. I did find that the factions are sometimes not in their camp, then you just want to switch the time of day a couple of times and then they will reappear and then you can do the conquest battle. And after you completed that, you can just go back to the fort and rinse and repeat. Again, thanks to It's Jordan Does for this tip. You can find a link to his video with other tips on how to level up fast in the video description. And of course, also smart when doing this tactic is to make sure that you got enough bounties, so maybe you can grab some of them while clearing the fort. Another tip, and this actually applies to everything I said in the video, and that is play the game on easy. Like, if you really just want to do this to rank up fast, then killing enemies faster and getting to the conquest battle faster, that you can then also faster complete, will save you some time. But also the naval bounties that give you a ton of XP can easily be done actually on a lower difficulty, so you destroy these ships in no time. So if you have a naval bounty and are not in the mood for some ship battles, then this can make it go way faster. And of course, while playing through the main story, doing some side missions, you will also get some nice XP. It will just not go as fast as the other tactics I mentioned. It is smart though to still always try and complete the locations that you visit for these missions, especially the big forts that you have to go to for these quests as well. Like, it's totally not that hard to kill the special enemy in that fort, loot all the treasures, and maybe save some people that are trapped there. If you then got everything from the checklist, you get a very nice, amazing XP reward. Totally drop your tips and tricks on how to level up fast and also, of course, get ability points in Assassin's Creed Odyssey in the comments down below. And I will be sure to highlight the best ones that I see. Totally subscribe for everything on Odyssey if you haven't already. And of course, the new Assassin's Creed that should launch this year. Like this video to support the channel and totally check out my previous video on the awesome Ezio armor that you sadly cannot get anymore. But if you got it, then I got some nice tips for it. For now though, I will speak to you next time and goodbye.